Hello everyone, my name is Paul and welcome to today's data analysis and visualization workshop on data cleaning in Python using Pandas. I've created this Word document that has some steps on how you can set up your environment. You could use Anaconda and create a virtual environment, or you could directly use pip and install the dependencies. We're going to use a Jupyter notebook to run our commands, but you're free to use the command prompt. So I'm not going to go into the steps of setting it up right now, but you can refer to the document. So let's get started. So I'm going to create a Jupyter notebook from the command prompt. The reason why I'm using a Jupyter notebook is it's much easier to visualize our data, as well as run multiple commands, view the results, and make changes. Okay, so let's create a new notebook. We're first going to import pandas, and we can give it an alias by saying import pandas as pd. Now, what exactly is pandas? It's basically a framework that allows you to create what's called a data frame. And a data frame can be thought of something like an Excel sheet or say a database table where you have rows and columns of data. And pandas is really good with manipulating data in these kind of formats. So let's first import one of the datasets that we used in the tableau workshop. So we're going to do pd.read.csv. And we're just gonna use the name of the file and this is gonna store it in our data frame df. So if you want to visualize what kind of data we have in this data frame, we can use the head command, and the head command prints the first 5 rows, but we can change it if we want to see the first maybe 10 or 100, etc. So here we can see that we have a list of countries along with the BMI value as well as BMI ranges. Suppose you want to get all the columns from your data frame, you can do df.columns. This is going to list out all the columns and return an array. We could then even query the data frame by maybe retrieving all the country names. So this is going to select the column country. And if we want all the unique country names, we can use the unique command. Now we're going to do something that we did in the Tableau workshop called pivoting. We're basically going to convert this data set from a non-tidy format to a tiny format. And the difference basically is here we have variables in the columns, which is not tidy. So we're going to convert it into a more concise table by having these columns as one column, and all these values is going to become the value of that column. So to do that in pandas, we're going to use the melt command. So we're going to do pd.melt. So we're going to provide the data frame and we have to provide the ID that we want to do the melt on. And then we need to provide the columns that we're going to use as the values. And here, what we're going to do is we're just going to use all the columns except the first one. So what this does in Python is it's going to return an array from the first one onwards. So let's see what it looks like. As you can see that all those columns have been merged into one column with the values as a second column. If we ever want to get our original data frame back, all we need to do is use the pivot command, but this is probably not going to work because we have duplicates. So let's just try. So if you see that the index contains duplicate entries, so we can't do that. So let's remove duplicates. So let's do by using the keep keyword, we can specify whether we want to keep the last one or the first one, etc. One of the reasons why we need to drop duplicates is our original table actually had duplicate country names here. So let's get rid of them. And now when we do the pivot, we get our original table back. Minus the duplicates, of course. Now let's go to splitting a column. So if you see that all these values have the BMI as well as the range, so let's split it into two columns each, and let's use our original ID table. So when you use .str, you can perform different string operations on this column. And what Pandas will do is it'll apply this operation to all the rows in the column. So we're going to split it based on an underscore. Okay, what expand equal to true does is it's going to return multiple columns. And we're going to set n equal to 1 because we want to split it only on the first instance of the underscore. We're going to do this both for the variable as well as the value column. So what this does is you can see that the variable column has been split into the year and then the sex. So now let's update it back into our original table. So to do that, we're going to do year and sex is equal to, and let's do this also for the BMI range. And if you can see that this was split on a space, so let's put it on a space. Okay, so let's look at our table, and it's been split. So now that we've split our columns, let's look at our data set and we can see that we don't need the variable and value columns anymore. So let's drop them. So to drop them, we can use the command drop. And we're going to use the labels variable and value. And we're going to give it an axis. One signifies columns and zero signifies rows. So we want to drop the columns. So oops, tidy dot drop. Okay. If we wanted to sort our data, we can use the sort command. So we use sort values and we can give a list of columns we want to sort on. So in this case, it's going to go ascending order of the country. We can change that by using ascending equal to false. And now it's descending order. We can also provide multiple country, multiple column names. So it's going to first sort on the country, then on the year, and then on the sex. Now let's look at joining with another data set. So let's import the continent data set that we have. So we're going to use the same read CSV command. We're going to use the data continent.csv. And this is going to fail because of the encoding of this Excel file. We need to provide the correct encoding information to Pandas to be able to read it. For more information on this, you can visit this website that talks about different standard encodings of files. So let's look at the first few rows of our continent dataset. We can see that we have the continent name, the continent code, the country name, and other codes that represent the country. So like we did in the Tableau workshop, we're going to join using a simple left join. So let's do tidy.join, and we're going to have to change the index because the index signifies this value. We want to join based on the country. So we need to change the index of both the continent so even for the continent, we're going to join it based on the country name. So and we're going to do it on the country. That's the index for the tidy table. And how we're going to specify a left join. Right now you can see we have our original data set along with the continent information. Now suppose we wanted to maybe get a subset of this data set. So in Pandas, we can use what's called a where, the where function or where clause. So we use join data.where and you need to specify the column. So we specify the column country and we wanna, let's say we wanna pick out all the records from the United States. If you try to look at this data, you'll see a lot of NANs. And the reason for this is when Pandas does this way, it's gonna return all the data that's present, as well as whatever was not equal, it's gonna return those rows with a NaN. So what we can do is just drop the NaNs. So we do drop NA, and we can specify which columns we wanna check for NaNs. So let's just check on country. You see now we've dropped all the rows that had country as NaN. That's it. Thanks everyone for joining. And let me know if you have any questions.